Very good afternoon to everyone. Okay, today I'm going to present a topic about complication that happened in healthcare. Before I start, my name is Nusha Fika binti Zainuddin. Okay, for our issue, I choose the issue on avoiding communicating medication error through effective communication in healthcare environment. Okay, first I will let me introduce you what means of the medication error. Which is a major problem that causing medication error is happen because of ineffective communication that happen between patient and health personnel. And second, communication is an essential means of the ensuring effective and improved medication. And in healthcare, there are a few of communication issues that happen. First, language barrier, medium of communication, physical setting, and social setting. Okay. Next, good communication error is practiced when the effective help and improve patient safety and hospital setting. Poor communication can cause on the adverse effect, delay in treatment, medication error, and wrong site surgery. Poor communication also causes from these all causes can we can overcome these causes by designing the strategy by using effective communication and teamwork among healthcare professionals and to influence the quality services and patient outcome. Issue that happen in healthcare environment. First, disrupting communication. Medical practitioner that use medical language, inadequate communications about patient medication, and also poor interprofessional communication. Next, okay, what is mean disrupting communication? Disrupting communication can endanger the safety and the quality of healthcare and finally lead to the medication error. Medication error also in order to raise awareness and need and on the need to improve patient safety. From these barriers to effective and off in a healthcare environment which includes language barrier, medium of communication, physical setting, and social setting. To improve the communication, by improve the communication that happen between patient and personnel, it can decrease the rates of medication errors in the hospital. Second, what means by medical practitioner, which is according to the study, nurse, doctor, and pharmacy fail to use simple language to communicate with the patient. Almost 90% health practitioners admit that they did not frequently use simple language when they communicate with the patient. So, because they does not focus on improving the patient care and leading to the medication complaints. Next, adequate communication about patient medication. Which is adequate communication about patient medication across the levels of the healthcare system that leads to the numerous and potentially harmful medication error. And from the adequate communication, we can causes on the adverse effect, delay in treatment, medication error, and also bring to the wrong site surgery. The decrease in the rates of adverse, improve the communication, can improve the communication between nurses and physicians. Next, okay, poor interpersonal communication, poor in the interprofessional communication, which is study conducted, that the study have conducted that they found that poor interprofessional communication is because of the busy in the hospital, and that can lead to the omission error. And the higher rates of the communication error during treatment can associate to the communication problem. and miscommunication also can contribute to the unsafe medication use. Poor practice and also can place patient at the risk medication error. And lastly, how to avoid this communication issue by using the effective communication. First, we have to improve the team and interpersonal communication to avoid this error. Second, use language in communicating appropriately, which is the nurse or any surgeon must avoid using the term that the medical term when they communicate with the patient. And third, complexity of the care process. They have to make sure the process is flow and the patient have to know what the process means. And lastly, choosing the best mechanism to deliver the message to the the message to the patient. And lastly, for effective good communication, practice the help the effective help communication, and also we can avoid all the causes, for example, adverse effect, delay in treatment, physical setting, also social setting, which is by improve the communication, we can decrease the rate of the medication error, and all the designing strategies on the communication error can influence the quality and can improve this, the quality of the hospital service itself. That's all for me. Thank you.